Welcome to the destruction of Sodom and Gomorrah. Now Sodom gets known for sodomy. Gomorrah gets known for that character from Marvel. Kind of unfair once you think about it. Yeah. Anyway, it's raining, and also if you might hear thunder in the background. Kind of an interesting ambiance for this. The two angels, literally, this is another reason why I say that wasn't the Trinity. It just literally calls the two angels in literally the next story. Arrive at Sodom in the evening, and Lot was sitting in the gateway of the city. When he saw them, he got up to meet them and bowed down with his face to the ground. "My lords," he said, "please turn aside to your servant's house. You can wash your feet and spend the night, and then go on your way early in the morning." "No," they answered, "we will spend the night in the square." But he insisted strongly that they did go with him and entered his house. He prepared a meal for them, baking bread without yeast, and they ate. Before they had gone to bed, all the men from every part of the city of Sodom, both young and old, surrounded the house. They called to Lot, "Where are the men who came to you tonight? Bring them out so that we can have sex with them." Lot went outside to meet them and shut the door behind him, and said, "No, my friends, don't do this wicked thing. Look, I have two daughters." Okay, let's just stop for a minute. Two strangers come in this city. The first, all the natives do besides Lot, "We need to have sex with them." These strangers show up and their first instinct is to rape them. Yeah. Two daughters who have never slept with a man. And Lot's like, "No, don't rape them. Rape my daughters instead." Yes, the Bible shows the wickedness of the world. "Let me bring them to you, out to you, and you can do what you like with them. But don't do anything to these men, for they have come under the protection of my roof." "Get out of their way," they replied, and they said, "This fellow came here as an alien, and now he wants to play the judge. We'll treat you worse than them." Ah, yes. Literally, who are you to judge? In the words, in the mouth of the bad guys, that's literally, who are you to judge? Which is a stupid argument. It's basically, yeah, I know what you're saying, what I'm doing is bad, but I don't want to admit it, so shut up. They kept bringing pressure on Lot and moved forward to break down the door, but the men inside reached out and pulled Lot back into the house and shut the door. So you never see like empty, just like the open door. Then they struck the men who were at the door of the house, young and old, with bitterness, so they could not find the door. With blindness, so they could not find the door. Not bitterness. The two men said to Lot, "Do you have anyone else here, son-in-law, sons or daughters, or anyone else in the city who belongs to you? Get them out of here, because we're going to destroy this place. The outcry to the Lord against its people is so great that he has sent us to destroy it." So Lot went out and spoke to his sons-in-law, who were pledged to marry his daughters. So where's Sodom and Gomorrah and these people going to other cities? And not just having sex with the men and women and whatever else, but forcibly on them and doing horrible, horrible acts while doing it. Yes, a lot of people are like, yeah, the sin of Sodom and Gomorrah, homosexuality. Yes, but it also seems like it's forced homosexuality. It's forced rape. It's probably pedophilia and a whole bunch of other gross and disgusting things. Anyway. Yes. Hurry and get out of this place because the Lord is about to destroy the city. But his sons-in-law thought he was joking. Like, no one's about to destroy the city. Ha ha, very funny. With the coming of the dawn, the angels urge Lot, hurry, take your wife and your two daughters who are here, or you will be swept away when the city is punished. When he hesitated, the men grasped his hand and the hands of his wife and of his two daughters and led them safely out of the city. You imagine seeing two angels dragging a family through a city. That's a sight. For the Lord was merciful to them. As soon as they brought them out, one of them said, flee for your life. Don't look back. Do not step anywhere in the plain. Flee to the mountains or you will be swept away. But Lot said to them, no, my lords, please. Your servant has found favor in your eyes, and you have shown great kindness to me in sparing my life, but I cannot flee to the mountains. This disaster will overtake me, and I'll die. Look, here is a town near enough to run, and it is small. Let me flee to it. It is very small, isn't it? Like, this little town is small, like, only a few buildings. It's really small. The damage is small. Then my life will be spared. He said to them, very well, I grant you this request too. I will not overthrow the town you speak of, but flee quickly because I cannot do anything until you reach it. God gave the angels the power to do this. Anyway. So whatever happened to Sodom and Gomorrah, it didn't happen to this one city. Interesting. By the time Lot reached Zoar, the sun had risen over the land. Then the Lord rained down burning sulfur on Sodom and Gomorrah from the Lord out of heaven. Wait, the Lord rained down sulfur on Sodom and Gomorrah from the Lord. Out of heaven. So the Lord is down that raining sulfur from the Lord. Yeah, it makes sense God would... it would make sense God came down to where the angels are. But if God came down where the angels are, there's the Lord raining sulfur down from the Lord. There is Trinity again. Thus he overthrew these cities and their entire plain, including all those living in the cities, and also all the vegetation in the land. But Lot's wife looked back, and she became a pillar of salt. Early the next morning, Abraham got up and returned to the place where he had stood before the Lord. He looked down towards Sodom and Gomorrah, towards all the land of the plain. He saw dense smoke rising from the land. Oh, yeah, that is why the town was called Zoar. Smoke rising from the land like smoke from a furnace. So when God destroyed the cities of the plain, he remembered Abraham, and he brought Lot out of the catastrophe that overthrew the cities where Lot had lived. Just watching this and like, whoa. Now!
Doesn't like focusing while my blue light muter's on because fine. Okay, well, there has been some talk way back in 2021, last year, about Sodom and Gomorrah. Sapiens.org calls it pseudoscience. Nature says no impact, evidence of impact. Flores Webb thinks there might be. New beliefs, archivist today. News benefits for July 28th, 2022. This seems new. Oh man, this website looks weird. Password. What does this have to do with Sodom and Gomorrah, Google? Also, this is... Oh, wait, no. Some of this is in German. Okay. Never mind. That's nothing to do with... Yeah, but then there's... here's the scientific meltdown over a controversial discovery of something. Of the biblical Sodom. I guess it just goes over, blah, 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 archaeologists, focusing, not really, but everything's backward. These scholars, more than half of the scientific pose, claim the destruction matrix, which they put around 1650 BC, is highly unusual in Near East. But last month, Stephen Jarnett, a postdoctorate fellow at American Museum of Natural History, and R. Scott Harris, a separate scientist at Atlanta Fairbanks Science Center, challenged these conclusions of the 21 scholars, also Nature, basically hinting that Collins' group confused a run-of-the-mill smelting and pottery process with heat from an arrow blast. Okay, but Huffer reminds us the scientific debate can proceed without ridicule. Walter and Ross, Tom Scarpa, in the 1970s and 80s, had advanced the idea that Belduraya and Nimrah were associated with Sodom and Gomorrah. He said their idea was evaluated by the discipline and rejection. I think Collins and his team should afford such a courtesy. So he's basically saying, don't be mad. Don't call them like stupid and stuff. Yes. Like, don't ridicule people. Huh. There's some stuff. I guess I can link this article too, and you can go read the comments. But what I'm mostly going to do is, because there hasn't been a real major update to this story, since the "We found Sodom!" Basically, dynamic, I'm just going to link this to Google News, and, well, you can just see if anything updates and go explore Google News, see if anything possibly comes out of it. Oh, maybe. Should I also? Possibly inspired a biblical story by Scroll In. Atlas Obscura? Sodom and Gomorrah. The Weather Channel. Why was the Weather Channel in this? Anyway! Inspiring Philosophy did a video called Sodom and Gomorrah Found, Biblical Archaeology. But he has made a comment. Since making this video, experts on meteorologic airbursts have begun to question if the site was destroyed by one. If further research reveals the site was not destroyed in an airburst, This video will be removed. Also, I just kind of want to share you the first comment. I'm not doing I'm
going to let you go back to the dark place because I'm not showing you these people's names. This one person says, there's no such thing as meteors as we know them today. Knows them. But what? What does that have to do with anything? I think this guy's just a weirdo flat earther. And then some other guy decides to share a pun. Abraham was the smartest man in the Bible. He knew a lot. Okay. Yes, someone said the idea of Lot's wife getting turned into a pail of salt always brought to mind a natural event for me anyway, and thinking of the remnant to Paul and Pei. Okay, yeah. Can I see that? Oh, I don't see that many. Oh, there's another. Someone's not a theist, but saying this theory may easily be confirmed though through independent geological tests. Okay. See, even a non theist. Yes. Does it? Anything else? I better go to news first. I might not have any conversations. Oh yeah, there are some old maps. Yeah, theories. This theory does not fit what the Bible says or what archaeologists have discovered elsewhere in the Dead Sea area. It kind of disproved that in the video where you're just misinterpreting the Bible. Anyway, why haven't you deleted this? Because really nothing else has come up. Someone's like, we found Sodom and Gomorrah, two articles. No, you haven't. That's been like the whole thing. Okay. Oh yeah, she didn't. Oh yeah, Lot's wife didn't follow Lot. Followed the destruction. I'm doing VTU. Inspiring philosophy sources. Discovering the City of Sodom by Stephen Collins. Bronze Age Cities Along the Dead Sea. Walter E. Rist. Life in the Early Walled Towns of the on the Dead Sea Plain near my Berdalia, Marist S. There's okay. Okay, evidence confirmed to Eldium Asylum Attest News. Where is Sodom, Bezibur? Yes, okay. Anyway, and yes, he had to respond to somebody who, like, did you really find it? And where he's like, yes, did someone call the Bible skeptic? Where he even, like, not a more northern location. Yes. So where he basically says, yeah, right, this is an odd interpretation, which does lead, well, it's one important part of Lot's journey. The text implies Sodom and Gomorrah were to the east of Bethel and Ai, because Lot started around Bethel and Ai, then moved east, which is where Sodom is. If I were to tell you I was in Los Angeles and was moving as far as Dallas, you would get the impression that it was moving east and randomly went off some other direction. You would not get the impression that it was moving east and randomly went off in some other direction. Therefore, have no clue where Dallas was in relation to a Los Angeles. You would think I was moving east until I got to Dallas. Likewise, in Genesis 3, yeah, basically it's like... Yes. Or in using Ezekiel 16, verse 46, one thing I noted in my video is that the Hebrew word for south actually means to the right of sea, versus like Genesis 13:9 and 24:49, 48:13 through 18, a bunch more in Ezekiel, does not necessarily mean south. In fact, in other places throughout Ezekiel, we see words used that definitely more mean south. It's like Ezekiel 20, verses 46 through 48, 41, 10 through 13. I'm not giving you the whole thing. You can read this yourself. Now, the word, it's in Hebrew, I don't know how to repeat it, can mean south if the direction of south is off to the right of the speaker, but it does not necessarily have to mean that. Could mean to the east, southeast, or south. Yes. Oh yeah, Zeor. Where is, he didn't mention because he doesn't know where it is, but here's like a map. Here's another map. Anyway, I'm just gonna read you the whole thing. This whole response. Okay. Yes, yeah, so anyway, and you can go, I just his old roller press, so you can go read all of the other stuff where debunks a whole lot of other crazy atheist ideas. They all off. Anyway, so a little bit of history about Etel Himanan. It was a site occupied in the Catholic, Early Bronze Age, Middle Bronze Age, and Iron Age, and Hellenistic, Roman, Byzantine, and Umayyad periods. Well, not the exact area, but the areas around it. Yeah. So, yeah, there's not much. About it, but anyway, there's one more thing, one more quick thing. Where is this place located? It's located right here by Rwanda. Here's the Dead Sea. Here's Amman, capital Jordan. Jerusalem is over. Oops. Jerusalem is what? There. Jerusalem's here. The Sea of Galilee is up there. It's raining out there still. Oh yeah, and there it is. It didn't take me right to the thing for some reason. Now, this thing has reviews. Because of course it does. Like, possibly it's an old city in Cana. First he spells Cana with a K, but that's not proven. Yeah, it's proven it's an old city. What are you talking about? Whatever. Okay, more people are talking about how it's... is Sodom. Wait, in this, Moses did a preaching of Deuteronomy on the day before the entrance of Canaan in the last 40 years. What does that have to do with anything? Who knows? But yeah, it does have reviews. Most of it having to reference the whole it being Sodom and Gomorrah. So that's Gomorrah. Anyway, here's some pictures. Here's a video. I hope that wasn't copyrighted. It's just 3 seconds. Here's another thing. Maybe turn the volume off and then play the video. Just looking around. Looking around. Well, I'm not going to definitively say this was Sodom. But I'm not going to definitively say it's not. There's just been a... well, not much about it, actually. Should I just look up Sodom and Gomorrah and see if any news... yeah, just in case any news thing comes from that. Maybe... anyway, go watch Inspiring Philosophy's video. Go watch my other videos. That is all. Goodbye.